charge the mountain all day long and get these suckers. So next time, maybe we'll have an elk. Next update.
I actually don't know what he's talking about, but whatever.
We'll see you back at camp.
Yeah, we're exactly. We're just waiting for it to stop raining so we can get back to camp.
Say a couple of Hail Marys.
Okay.
And take a shot of whiskey.
Okay, I'm good with both of those. So
and we don't have any whiskey here with us.
So it ain't gonna happen. We're screwed.
We're gonna screw it up.
Hey. So a little update. We're just having lunch. It's actually, I think, a little after one already. And we heard another faint bugle. So on our way to that, right in line with that, we actually spotted some elk up on the ridge that where I'm sitting right now. But they were on private. There's just a small section of public that drops over this ridge, just a little corner. So we were down below. There were, I think altogether there were nine, and there was a big bull in there. I have some video of it. So we got their attention. We called and looked like maybe they kind of started coming our way, but they were about 300 yards away, 330 yards away. And tried coaxing them over. We put up the decoy. We called. We bugled. I mean, we did everything we could think of to try to get them to come and investigate or just come over. And they just would not. And after bugling a few times, which was kind of the last resort, the bull, he was a good bull. He pushed them all over the top of the ridge and out of sight. We waited a while. We kept calling to see if maybe he would peek back over, and nothing. So we decided we'd come up to this little point that crosses over and just see if, like, somehow we could get close enough where we could coax him to come across the line. So we got up here, and we've been up here now for about 3 hours, a little over 2 hours maybe. And we found him eventually. We didn't see him, but he did bugle. We did some cow calling. He did bugle. And so we did relocate him, but same thing. Like, he would not. He was down below us. They were probably down below us about 200 yards or so, and we were at the line. So we just could not get him to come to us. So we did some raking and bugling and cow calling, and eventually they just shut up, and that was the end of it. So now we're eating lunch. Gary just got done taking care of business. And did you finish your paperwork?
Yep.
And now we're deciding what we're going to do next. Think we have a plan. Gonna probably go to an area we haven't been before, but try to get a little bit closer to some water sources. The area that we're in has no water, zero. So we're kind of handicapped. Like, we don't have anything that way. They're all kind of, they move away from us or stay out of this area because there's no water. And obviously we can't cross into the private. So I think we have a spot we're gonna go check out that gets as close to water as possible. And we'll see if something else changes our mind on the way, then we'll go with that. But otherwise, that's where we're headed for the afternoon and evening. So more later. Gary,
yeah.
Parting words of wisdom.
I'm not a very wise man. That comes pretty tough.
Yeah.
Best I can say is shoot straight.
You said that last night. You can't do that, or yesterday morning. You can't use it again. You can't use it again.
Okay, let's.
How about this would be relevant? How about wipe twice?
Are you watching me? Wipe twice.
Okay, whatever. It's time to end it. Thank you.
last night of our full day. And it's blowing like you probably can't hear me, it's blowing like gusts of 40 miles an hour. I just had a cow right by that tree right there. And it's about 100 yards from where I'm at right now. Walked out across that saddle wide open. I didn't think anything would be out there in this kind of wind. Got busted by her, because I didn't expect anything to be out here, so I don't know if you can even hear this or not, but this is our last night, so probably not much happening tonight. What do you think about this wind?
Really?
Yeah.
It blows.
Oh no.
Hey,
oh,
you open the door.
Yeah.
You open the door, right?
No more dad jokes.
Fall over because the wind just takes your pack like a sail.
Nugget. Yeah, we're calling it. We're wrapping it up. It's probably only about 30 minutes left, so it's kind of pointless, and probably won't be any video or audio that you can hear to this anyway, so that's it. Well, Gary, I think it's a wrap.
I think so.
Friday morning, pretty close to 9 o'clock. The wind just kind of stopped in the last like 30 minutes maybe. Now it's absolutely gorgeous. But we gotta get back to camp, break it down, get ready for helicopter coming. Pick us up, so that's it.
Big goose egg.
Tag soup, but great trip. It was a ton of fun.
We could throw the sheds in the tag soup.
Yeah, we got a few things to, in addition to the memories. Until next time.